Start it for a minute because I have to oil the air filter, but I just want to hear it running. On. Should just start right up. She hasn't been started in 30 years, so. Come on, little girl, you can do it. Of course, when I'm out here last night, it starts off like first kick. But. Oh, how dare. It's a little more than that. But. Thank you. take a little while.
Yeah.
At least it started, though. Had to clean the carburetor. It was all just completely gummed up, and now it starts and runs good, and it's not leaking gas anymore either. So, dinner now. Well. Right on, Jeff. The clutch isn't grabbing, I'm gonna have to adjust it or something.
Oh, please. Well, you do the adjustments and come and get me, and I'll be back for more. Yeah.
So when I had the bike, the clutch cable was really loose, and then I started the bike and it tightened back up again, so it was like I was holding the clutch lever down even though I wasn't, so it wasn't able to let go. I loosened it way off and I could feel it just start to grab, but I haven't actually driven it yet.
Okay.
We'll see here. This has been an ongoing project since last June. Here we are from June 2023 to June 2024. Had to be set aside for a few different reasons for a while, but here we go. Hee Justin, right on rock and roll. Ain't noise pollution. Chukutakadiha.
Right on.
got a swarm. That's my first ever swarm. At least that I've seen.
Yeah.
I got a few clips too. This ladder is sturdy enough. Check this out. Swarms are known for being gentle, so I can just go like this. Scoop up a nice little handful of these. This is neat. I'm just hanging out. If I shake them off, they'll just fly right back up to the swarm. They're not mean at all. They have nothing to protect. They'll just fly right back up there. Queen should be in there. Well, she'll be in there somewhere. I'll have to shake them into a box, and then hopefully they, like, stay there. Alright, I think it's just from all the cool, wet weather, they've been stuck in the hive a lot. So even though I have supers on and they have space, they just get crowded being stuck in there. And this is swarm season, May and June, so... kinda neat. Alright, and then I got a bottom board and a super drawing comb. I took the three frames out of the middle to give room for bees. Nice drawn comb, it smells like honey. Bees will just love this. Good thing I had the extra lid and bottom board and the boxes around.
Yeah.
I'm probably gonna have to take the grass off there. Trying to figure out which hive swarm. Usually on a big hive it would be the one that's not really got a lot going on. This one, I was wondering if it was going to swarm, but there's a lot going on here. There are bees flying, bringing in honey. These nukes shouldn't bother swarming. They're small and I just put queens in, so I don't think that any of them would have swarmed. For all I know, it could be like from somebody else's hives, but that'd be pretty unlikely since it's right next to the bee yard. I've been told that they usually land about 100 yards away from where your hives are, and then they'll look for a new home and fly away somewhere, so I gotta get them into a box here. Not this one. A good chunk of the bees would be gone, so it's not this hive. It looked like this a week ago. It looked like this yesterday. Not that one. It could just be a mediocre hive that was trying to reclean itself, and then it decided to swarm off, too. Good ones. My strongest hives. That's good. I'm not really sure which one it came out of. I'll have to see next time I go through them. I'm gonna have to just saw the branch off and then shake them into the box, because that's, I can't hold the box up there and shake them in there.
No.
It's too dangerous.
So why do you put them in smaller boxes?
Okay, so they're started in smaller boxes sometimes, just because I can put less bees in there. These ones, I'm going to winter them as 2 4-frame boxes. It just takes up less resources. You can also start them with less bees, and since they're tighter together, they can keep warm better, and then they'll grow faster. I try to face them all in different directions, just so it looks different and it's easier for the queens to orient to their spot. Lots of different landmarks. Usually my boxes are different colors, most of these are the same, but at least they're all in different directions, so it looks different. See, if they were all facing the same way and they're all the same color and everything looks the same, well, it's a lot more difficult for them to recognize which one is theirs. Everything looks different, so it's easier, hopefully. It seems to work. See, I'm guessing it's probably one of my mediocre hives that swarmed. It was probably trying to requeen itself, and then it just decided, hey, we might as well swarm and double our chances.
Get him on it. Oh, here he is.
Potter.
Man, it's so smooth.
Okay, have a good one. Okay, so a lot of this tobacco was started indoors. Here's the nice root on her. Ready to roll. Rabbit back in his home. Hi guys. How's the BBs doing? Oh, whoa, whoa. Is he getting bigger and bigger every day, Jedi? Yeah. And Mama's Molly. She's a sweet girl. Yeah. Okay, I gotta go put Rabbit in his home. Yeah. He had a camp over last night. Yeah. Maybe you can have a camp over too soon. It's nice enough you guys can stay outside. Yeah. Okay. Hi, Goose. How's you doing? No. I'm gonna take this off now. Hold on. There you go, hey? See you later, Rabbit. And Handsome Goose. I'll give a few extra. So Justin says that he's got another swarm. He's starting to wonder if they're neighbor's bees or something, because he can't find any of his hives that they'd be swarming from.
Two separate swarms.
The bees are out today, but they're not in an angry mood or anything. They're all happy and just doing their own thing. Like, I don't feel like they're gonna try and get me today, so that's good, they're not grumpy. Okay, you got this box over here because of the swarm?
Yeah, I just shook them in there.
You just shook them in there, okay.
They're all spread out right now. I think that that's a separate swarm. I think that's another one.
Because when I shook them in there, they stayed here. And if I missed the queen, they would have all flew back to the branch. They're hanging on this one.
Oh, yeah.
I actually weighted the branch down. It was hanging like this.
Huh.
Yeah, they had the branch all weighted down. It was hanging like this.
You shook them down and into there?
Yeah, and I think that that's a separate swarm. Because I already shook bees into this one, and they're all staying here. And then there's still a ball of bees there, so I think that's another swarm.
Huh.
I'm going to grab another box.
Well, if they're not your bees, then what, you think the neighbors?
They could be. It would be kind of weird that it's right in the bee yard. But
yeah.
I can't figure out which one of mine is swarming. I mean, that one, that more looks like orientation flights to me. The one with a bunch of bees out front.
Yeah.
And I pop the lids on them, and they're all still full of bees, so...
Huh. It's a mystery of the bee world.
Now that could look like swarming, and I think that's just orientation flights. They fly out for a minute, they memorize what the hive looks like, and then go back inside. Okay, there's the other swarm. I gave it 2 frames of honey, and I also gave it a little pail of syrup, because it's hungry.
Ah, here I see some wild plantain growing. This is very good if you cut your finger, and you can use it in ointments as well for healing the skin. I've used it as a bandage with some yarrow. Yeah, yeah. You can also eat the leaf, but it's kind of hairy and stuff, so... I wouldn't eat it, but it works great for bandages. Bandages. Rolling around your owie. You're gonna need a few. This is just a baby one that I spotted out here. They grow little white flowers and like stalk up and then little white flowers. Okay. Plantain. Hi, handsome boy. Okay, so this tobacco I just transplanted the other day, and it was weeping this morning because of the heat, and I had to figure a way to give it water, and so I just grabbed some sticks and gave it shade that way. And it's quite shaded down below. And it's still able to get water. Keeper's work is never done. Oh my god. I had these 2 mint plants in the hangers over there, indoors, in the indoor gardening. I figured she needs a spark of outdoorness, and I might take them out of those hangers and put them in the ground somewhere where hopefully they'll come back next year, but I'm undecided, so they can just hang out there. The dill around the borders is all nice and coming up. Hopefully those three little tobaccos do okay. Tobaccos, right there. Right on, she perked right back up. That's nice. Her leaves were laying on the ground and she was stressing from the heat and not enough water. Now I gotta bring the water and give the dogs a top off. This here is pineapple weed. It commonly just grows wherever. Let's pluck this one. Pineapple weed. You can use it for tea, but don't overdo it. It can be quite potent. And it's a nice flavor. I've had it before just to check it out. It's commonly used for colds and coughs. And hello, hello. We got some white clover just implanted just by the house here. And here we got some iced coffee that I whipped together last night. All I did was make it a little extra strong, brewed it. My usual method of brewing is using this with a jar thing, and in there we let the coffee filter, and I boil the water with a kettle. I used this coffee and a little bit of this shit mixed in. Very good. Brewed it a little bit stronger than I normally would for when you're just having coffee. Then in the glass jug I added milk, like 3% whole milk. I added whole whipping cream, I added some flavored caramel cream, a little bit of sugar. I wish I had brown sugar rather than the white, but I ran out of brown, because the brown sugar always gives it an extra caramel-like effect. And then I actually added some maraschino cherry juice in with that. Let's get some going on. Okay, I'm just gonna stick that back in the fridge because she's mighty warm today. Let's have a peek in here. I made a macaroni salad. We've been feasting on that. Looks as though it was a cat with like in it. Little fart. And of course, after I brewed it, I took this pot and stuck it in the fridge because it is metal. You wouldn't want to do that with a regular coffee pot because the glass may break on you by doing that. So you'd want to put, if you do use a coffee pot, you'd want to put it in the coffee into something else that won't crack from the heat and the cold combined. Voila! Now let's go outside and enjoy that. I think that's good enough for that area. This looks like a nice spot to have a nice coffee. Over here in this spot, got a tree down. Tree down, tree down. And Justin will cut that out of there when he has a little bit of time, when he's not working his bees or what have you, doing other projects. He's been working hard this summer. Would have been a nice added bonus to put some crushed ice in there or something. But that's okay, it's great by itself. Hot air. This one probably swarmed. Yeah. Could have swarmed yesterday or a week ago, you said, eh? With all this rain, that's what's making them swarmy.
That's it then.
Yeah, right on. Got everything on the list. The basil doesn't look all that happening.
No, he said he's had two heart surgeries, so.
Big bale of dirt. Push pause. Dream gonna drive home for me?
Well, another $2.50 on groceries. Went from cutting the grass to weed whipping now, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so I'll be collecting winter feed for the rabbit. A patch of alfalfa that I let grow. And down in here, there's a whole bunch more alfalfa that came up. So I'll just collect some of that and trim her all on back in here. This whole area. Now I have this one here and this one here. Let's do it. There's the first two hanging up in the tree there. Normally it'd be better to hang them up in a shed so they stay dry if it rains, but I don't have enough space in a shed at the moment to do so. Okay, so here's the large bale of dirt that I generally like to use. SunGrow Professional Growing Mix. Large bale, there you go, 107 liters. This big monster says, I take over, I. Well, you've met your maker, motherfucker. Oh!
look at that. Wow. I can see my lilac plant. Or bush. So I'm just going to trim back these lemon balms, get them into that new home like I've been talking. You can also take clips at this point too, just cut, break it like you would with the mint at the nodules and stick it in your water. There we are. Okay, and the rest I'm just going to put into the dry tray. Okay, there is the lemon balm that I'm harvesting. Here are the two, and they're all trimmed down. And I did take about 5 clips. Okay, so here I've got the pond started. I have dirt in there from the garden and some manure mix and some topsoil mix. I'm going to also add this bag. The year of the frogs. Okay, so I got to open this up, put some dirt in there, get her going on, and make these baby girls a new home. She likes the new table. Yeah. Do you like it, the new table? Yeah. She was rolling around on it. It doesn't even have a leaf in it. She wants a little splash of cream.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Here. I'll get her a bowl or something.
Let's go with this. Let her look it up. I get to have it cream on the new table. Yay! She's like, oh yeah. No, you don't need more.